good to see you again. How have you been? Oh, a little stressed. Well, let me help you out, okay? Just a moment. Just relax. Okay. I want to apologize for not being here last video. I was away on urgent matters. Before we talk about episode 3 of the 5th season, which has just been outstanding, if you ask me, we're first going to go over comments left on the previous Whispering Dead video, okay? Is that all right with you? Okay. These are comments that may have been left by you and other viewers. It's just a chance to interact with other fans of the show. Okay. But that's not all. Oh, no. I also have... wooden blocks. So, at some certain times throughout this video, Frank is gonna help you to just relax and get some tingles. Okay, is that okay with you? It's kind of my way of just making this moment with you a little bit more special, okay? Okay. So, before we talk about season episode 3, we're going to first go over comments. Let me just grab my phone here. Oh, thank you. Yes, this is a bubble wrap protective case. I made it myself. See, it to warn you that there may be some spoilers in this video. Okay? So, I wanted to warn you first. Style 63 says, I love how they follow the comic book, even if you have read it, you'll be surprised. Thanks, AMC and Fairwift. Thanks for your comment. Yeah, especially this season, I heard that they are following the comic books a little bit more this season. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. So where was I last video? Yeah, I was visiting my friend Dave. He's a deep one. Oh, you know Dave. He did his first ASMR video. He didn't even tell me. I can't believe that son of a... anyway, that's another time. Yeah. Julia Yan says she was so confused as to why Bob was crying, but I think he was bitten by a walker in the waters. So he knew his life was ending, which was why he was being so affectionate towards Sasha. Not sure if that's what the girl's called. Yeah, that's her name, Sasha. Well, as we'll get to in this, after the viewer comments, we'll find out if Bob was bitten or not. You definitely find out in this episode, yeah. I don't want to say anything just yet. A little spoiler here. Episode, knowing that he is an actor in The Wire, and he kind of said that he wishes the series had more unknown actors, and I can agree with that. I like watching movies and TV shows, etc., where there are some unknown actors, you know, that you haven't really seen. So, which is why I kind of enjoy watching independent movies, because a lot of independent movies have actors you never even heard of. So. 16. Without you, what's your favorite drink? Oh, yeah? Yeah, okay. Connor HPZ Gaming asks, how do I get my Walking Dead comics? He buys the volumes whenever I have a bit of spare money. Well, I buy the trade paperbacks. I found out about the comic book before the TV show, but the comic book was already around for about 3 years or so. So I didn't start. There was about 50 comics out by the time I found out about it and it became popular. It was too expensive to get the number one and all the comic books after. So, a lot of other folks brought up the topic about Bob being Dale. So, Sound Haven says she doesn't watch The Walking Dead except for when her boyfriend drags her into watching it. Well, you better start watching it, Missy, even if your boyfriend isn't around or whatever. So, no excuses. In the comics, she was younger, didn't have a husband, but committed suicide before the prison fell. Thank you, Drew Griffles, for that comment. I couldn't remember that. It's been a while. It's been like 2 years since I read the actual comics. Trade paperbacks. Looking here to see what some of the comments are. Let's see. This is a little bit of a spoiler about episode 3. So if you haven't seen the episode that we're going to talk about here in a few minutes, then you just might want to put your fingers in your ear holes there and just hum Whistling Dixie for a couple seconds or so. Dr. Death Defying says, I know exactly what the priest is hiding just because of the signs. He kept people from coming into his church so he could eat all the food and keep it to himself and left everyone else outside to die. Because of the scratches on the side of the church trying to get in and saying he will burn. Well, we pretty much find out the answer to that in this third episode. So, very good. I'm not sure if I thought of that or not. Let's lot of talk about that. Matthew Rodriguez says, the only problem with DC is that it could be overrun like Atlanta, or even worse. So how are they going to deal with that? Also, this Eugene guy is kind of sketchy. How come he won't say anything? And why is he so necessary? Well, I can't give anything away. You just have to find out for yourself. It would be cool to see them get to DC. I really hope they do. It would be great to see a post-apocalyptic DC. Don't you agree? Just a moment, please. How about some crinkles? Just do a little crinkles over here and you're right here, okay? A relaxing sound, isn't it? Yeah, I love the sound of crinkles. Crinkle, crinkle, crinkle. Yeah, crinkle, crinkle. Yeah, crinkles, crinkles. A little bit better, yeah. When I was visiting, Dave, he taught me elder speak. Someone said Terminus wasn't in the comic books, so thank you, whoever said that. Thank you for that. Okay, let's see. Kyle Whitaker says, do you think Beth is in the car or somewhere completely different? Are they leading Carol and Daryl in a trap? I don't really know. I'm not too familiar with that scene and whether it's in a comic dogs or not. But at the end of episode 3, we get a little sneaky peek of what happens to Beth. Kind of reminds me a little bit of that, The Last of Us and the end of it. Okay, Jacob Bocolo says the cannibals are frustrating to me. We don't want to do this. We have to. How many people has Rick eaten, let alone every single individual he came across at that point? Scavenging, hunting other animals, and cultivating the land are all options and easier to manage that we've seen. They've just gone insane from whatever happened to their people. Nothing more, nothing less. That's kind of my what I was thinking a little bit when I was watching the episode on TiVo, because I wasn't able to watch it when it first came out. I visited with Dave, but I can understand going crazy in a post-apocalyptic world, but just because you get brutally attacked and raped, I don't want to say that word, things like that, all of a sudden you turn and start eating other people. You gotta give a little suspension of disbelief, but I just don't think you just make a switch and start eating people. Not trusting people, yes. But turning into a cannibal, I just don't think so. So, what anyway? What are you gonna do? Just a few more here. Let's see. Come on. Justin Washburn says, I'm really enjoying this season. It reminds me so much of season 1. Also, the scene with Bob bothered me a lot more than I thought it would. Really terrifying stuff there. Can't wait to see where this season leads. Yeah, me too. The first season was great. Next couple of seasons were alright. No, not bad, not bad. Good stuff, but so far this season is just out of the park. All right. Okay, well, thank you everyone for your comments. I really do appreciate it. We're not trying to copy off of Talking Dead. I know there's a show AMC runs after The Walking Dead. We're not trying to copy off that show at all. We're just huge fans, just like you are, just trying to wait to talk, that's all. So start to talk about this next episode. How about some wooden blocks, huh? You like that? Okay. And just get all right here. There we go. Okay. Just some wooden blocks right here. Just like that. Just like that. Yeah. Just thinking, what if I pretended I was funded by Ross, huh? That kind of cool. Get a Bob Ross wig. And, undead Bob Ross. I don't think anybody's done that. Not that it matters, but kind of cool. Okay. There we go. Tapping and crinkling, you know. Yeah, so great things right there. Nothing quite as good as tapping and crinkling. Yeah. Tapping. Who needs springs when you got wooden blocks and crinkly plastic? Relax, my good friend. Okay. Well, now it's time to talk about episode 3. So, what did you think about it? Did you like episode 3? Such a lot of things happened. More than I thought. So we're gonna talk about it. Alright, so if you haven't seen it, you might not want to watch this part of the video. Okay. So, episode 3. Wow. That was great. So, we find out that Bob was infected, just like a lot of you folks guessed. So, that was kind of expected. Poor Bob, though. It was, a shame what happened to Bob, and it was a little touching there at the end with him and Sasha and then Tyrese. Poor Bob. So, but yeah, so he was infected and then he started to laugh. You know, it's funny, when he was crying, in my mind, I was thinking about and start laughing. Not because he was infected, but something was telling me from my unconscious why she's gonna start laughing. Just because all of a sudden the crying became kind of a there was some focus drawn and his crying became more pronounced. And maybe my unconscious was kind of telling me that he's going to start crying because laughing. I'm going to go from crying to laughing. Which we've seen before in various movies and shows where the victim starts crying and they started laughing. And then the person that's holding them captive is like, what's going on? And big surprise and all that. That's a classic little thing. I don't know what you call that. But works every time, almost. Yeah, So then Garrett kicked him, and they dumped Bob back at the church. Tyrese didn't kill the guy at the cottage, at the cabin, with the hood. So that was interesting. Some of you, or some folks, I think, mentioned that, but yeah, he was still alive. So Tyrese really can't kill. He doesn't have it in him. He'll beat the crap out of you, but he's not gonna kill you. Of course, that could have changed now. The remains to be seen. He did kill Bob at the end. Just like to hear this stuff in your ears. Has anyone ever stirred ice in your ear? Has a nice little clicky. Reminds me of, like, you know, when you're a kid, lemonade, iced tea, you know, summer days, hot summer days, getting a nice cold drink, you know. Very mean of him to do. I had a feeling that's what he did. So that was his dirty secret. And don't think he was in group. And I guess the Terminus group is the one that marked the trees so they could find their way back and stuff. So red hair. Who the heck has red hair around here? Anyway. Let's see. What else? So, yeah. So the term and his crew dropped Bob off at the church, and then Rick and company left to hunt down Terminus once the priest told them where the school was, because Bob told them where he was being held. So were you like me when you saw Rick and his crew leave the church, and then the camera just stood there, and then you saw the Terminus crew come out of the woods and go towards the church? Were you like, really, Rick? Y'all just leave the church? And don't you think that the other group could be waiting for you to do that? Huh? I was like, seriously? But then we saw what happened to the Terminus gang, because Rick and company did think that the Terminus gang was expecting them to leave, and so they waited for the Terminus gang to go into the church, and they took care of business. Now, I did not, I mean, it was awesome. I'm glad that Rick and crew were smart enough to make it obvious that they were leaving to hunt down Terminus group, and then they stayed and waited for Terminus to show up at the church. So both groups were kind of one step ahead of each other, but Rick's group was one step ahead of Terminus. So that was kind of cool. It was like a bait and switch from both groups, so to speak. Just about to bust down the door where Judith and Carl were when Rick and company show up. And they take out two of the Terminus gang. Then Rick shoots off Garrett's fingers, shooting his gun out of his hand. And then what happens next to the Terminus gang, I did not expect from Rick and company. They just slaughtered the Terminus gang. Not expecting that, were you? Did you expect that to happen? I wasn't quite sure what to expect from that scene. What I did not expect, Rick and Michonne, and I wonder who else, I can't remember. they were taking out a lot of pent up anger and such. I really wasn't expecting that at all. I was conscious. There was one scene where Tyrese was in the doorway like this, watching what just happened, and then he was like, he just backed away from the door. He didn't want any part of that. That was great. I can see that becoming a meme, Tyrese, in that doorway like that. And I think even Glenn and Maggie were shocked too, I think. But that was a brutal scene. They deserved that. They deserved that. I would have just put a bullet in their heads or like chop off their legs and set them outside for the zombies to eat. I kind of expected that to happen, but wow. Rick just choked out a machete and just started hacking up Garrett. You like this format of this series. I thought I would make it a little bit more special, just not just for you, for fans of the show, but for anyone else who may not be watching but enjoys binaural ASMR. So yeah. And that reminds me about Glenn and Beth. How about that surprise ending? Were you expecting that? How about Abraham and his gang leaving with Glenn and Maggie? Is that something else? So now, the question is, I guess, are we going to be following Glenn and Maggie and Abraham's group off and on throughout the rest of the season? So, that's quite interesting. I think I know of something that happens to Glenn in the comic books. So, but I haven't gotten up that far, so I don't really know what's in store. The TV show is kind of, seems to me, taking a little bit of a turn away from what's happening in the comic books, although they're still keeping some of the same storylines. Such. So, remains to be seen, I guess. Anyway. So, yeah. So that's gonna be interesting. Are we gonna follow Abraham's group with Glenn and Maggie off and on throughout the season? Or what's in store for them? Are they gone for a few episodes? I'm assuming we might have one episode of just Abraham and Glenn and Maggie. Kind of like what they did last season with the different groups split up. So, let's sounds for you here. There we go. Brushing. Brushing. Who needs brains when you got tapping? And crinkling. Yeah. These are just some of the things that you can expect me to provide you in the future. Not just here within this particular series. Anything else? I just don't think there is. I think I talked about everything pretty important for the most part. Hear from you, what you thought of the episode, what you think about the season so far, what your thoughts are about Glenn and Maggie separating from the group. Her because she had to cure, or they just messing with Beth, not for that reason, but who knows what more twist. twisted stuff in store, I guess. Alright, well that's it. Well, what I'm gonna do here at the end of each episode here is just kind of lull you to sleep. I'm just gonna give you a nice scalp massage, okay? And then I'm going to just whisper some elder speak. Some people call it elder speak. Others call it shadow speak. But it's glossolalia, gibberish. So it's all kind of the same thing. Okay. Thanks for watching. And take care of yourself. Stay well. Try not to get too stressed out. And we'll see you next week. Don't forget your comments. And we'll get some of your comments next week. Alright, take care. And good to see you again. Alright, now it's time to go to sleep.